Okay, hi everybody. So today I'm just adjusting the geometry on the front wells. So I usually do this by myself at home. Been doing this for about 10 years now, and I think it gets good results. I don't didn't notice any uneven wear on tires, so I think it's good. This is a method I'm using. So to start, I'm doing this by myself, so if you have a helper, it might help a little bit, get it faster. Here goes. So I use a tape like this. I will count in millimeters because it's easier for me. And what I did, you can see, I did attach the tape on the other well, on the other tire actually. This is these are winter tires, which are kind of harder to get the right measure on them. Summer tires will be better, but anyway. So as you can see, I took a reference. My reference is this this side of the tread. So this side of the tread, I measure in the back of the rear the tire. It shows about 166. Sorry, here you go. It shows about 166. Centimeters, maybe 161, 162. I did the same measure in the front side of the tires. So fixed the tape the other side, the other tire, fixed it, measured here, and I did measure at the exact same height. That's important. So the exact same height point on the tire, and I did measure again against this reference that I took for myself. I'll show you the other side. So that's how I, well, self-attach the tape. You can use whatever you find to be good for you. But so I used to measure from this point to the other point. This is the rear measure. And then I did also attach the tape here, and I did the front measure. And the values, so this one in the rear is 166. When I did measure like 5 minutes ago in the front, I got 167, which means, let's show this, 166 and 167. If I stay towards the front of the car, this is the front of the car, it means the tire, the front wells, are at this moment set, I'm going to exaggerate a bit, are set like this, 167, 166. So the adjustments on the geometry, I need to do it in such way to bring the tire parallel. And okay, so to do this, I can do it in several ways. One way, it's to adjust both sides the same amount, they will get parallel. The other way will be to adjust one side maybe a little more when the car will be driving afterwards. So I'm adjusting just one side, the car will set the wheels like this. So as you can see, this is another way to set the wheels parallel. And finally, you can do the same thing on the other side. So adjust the right wheel like this. When the car will be driving, the wheels will get parallel. Depends how much you adjust one side. The important thing here is that depending which side you are adjusting, it will set the steering wheel either straight, to be straight when you go in a straight line, either off center. So what you want is to have the steering wheel straight at 12 o'clock when you go straight with your car. And my steering wheel at this moment, when I was going straight with the car, was looking like this. Not sure you can see it, it's very slightly off center. So when I was driving on highway and stuff, it was very slightly on the left, turned on the left. So the deal here will be, if I adjust only the left well, both wells when I will be driving next time the car, both wells will go like this, and the steering wheel, let's say this is a normal steering wheel, will be turned like this. So look again, if I adjust this well, imagine this is the steering wheel, it's at 12 o'clock now, but when the car will be driving, it will turn the steering wheel to the left. And I show you, my steering wheel is already turned to the left, so this is not what I want. So instead of adjusting this wheel, I will be adjusting only the right wheel. And look what happens. Remember, my steering wheel is to the left. I want it to turn to the right. I adjust this wheel normally, and then look, the steering wheel will be turning a little bit to the right. So this is the whole idea, is to adjust